Hey ladies, happy Sunday everyone. How are you all doing? Yeah, it feels so good to be here once more to share some knowledge with all of you. So as we all know, this week we celebrated the Children's Day all over the world, and so we'll be discussing on the topic about children and parenting. So that's it. So I'm going to tell you what role you need to play in your child's life, what is recommended, what is required of you as a parent to instill values on your children, okay? So parenting is not all about being too rigid with your decision on your children. You know, rather it's something that should be flexible and, you know, set your limits, set the boundaries, be firm with your, you know, when you're trying to set boundaries with your children, you know, be kind, do not neglect your children, do not try to be permissive, do not try to be an authoritarian parent, and if possible, be an authoritative parent. I'm going to explain it to you ladies later. Because we have four types of parenting. You know, this research has been done by a lady called Diana Baumrind. She's an American woman. She's a psychologist. So she found out that this way to be a good parent or way of parenting style is being divided into these four categories, and which I just mentioned. So I'm going to explain further what's are their roles, what they really means, okay, their meanings individually. So their meaning differently. So I'm going to explain. So the first one, like I said, you know, and this lady, she has a theory, she has a parenting style theory, which she said the theory is there is a close relationship between the type of parenting style and children's behavior. Okay, this is what her theory is. Different styles of parenting can lead to different child developments and child outcomes. Okay, the way you do your parenting will determine how the child outcome will be. So, the first one I'm going to talk about, you know, remember I said four types of parenting styles. Okay, parenting styles, which are permissive, authoritative, neglective, and authoritarian. Okay, so the first one is the permissive parents. These parents, this type of parents are not demanding. Kids do not have many responsibilities and are always allowed to regulate their behavior and majority of their choices. When a parent is permissive, they look at their child as equal rather than children of a parent. Do you get that? For example, that's an example for this kind of permissive parent. So what this parent does is that, example is that, may let their children stay up late, even though they need to get up early the next day for school. Asking their child to do tasks, but at their own convenience. For example, regularly asking their children to put away his or her toys after playing, but only if they are not feeling too tired. If this is what you do, you are considered as a permissive parent. Okay, and again, a permissive parent do not control or regulate their children's behavior. In other words, their children are less aware of the limits of acceptance behavior. They do not understand what the limits are. So they always exhibit worse impulse control and have more behavioral problems. When facing stressful, when this kind of children that have been, you know, that their parenting is permissive. So when facing stressful situations, they are more likely to resort to using aggression. So this is not a good parenting style. Okay, that's what it is in conclusion. So the second one is what is called a neglectful parent. In other words, it means parenting that are not involved, uninvolving parents. Okay, so this kind of parenting, which obviously carries out more negative connotations, is a style of parenting where parents don't respond to their children's needs or desires beyond basic of food, clothing, and shelter. This is not all that a child needs. Because you're feeding the child, you give the child food and clothe the child, that means you're a good parent. No. So this is neglect. It's considered as a neglectful parent. Okay? So they leave their children to fend for themselves. Another example of neglectful parents is when parents don't provide meals for their parent, for their child. So remember the other one is like, you know, they provide, you know, beyond basic of food. Okay, maybe they just leave food, you can take care of yourself, feed yourself. But this type of, another example that I'm trying to explain here is, you know, when parents don't provide meals for their child. Okay, so they just let you do it yourself. The other one, they just leave it for you. They don't even want to know if you're eating or not. That's the other one. But this one is that they don't even provide at all. So two of them are neglectful as well. Okay, so what does that mean? If they are busy working and the child asks them what is for dinner, the parent might tell them to heat up a microwave dinner and leave them to eat it on their own. You are a neglectful parent if this is what you do. So how does neglective parenting affect a child? A parents with little empathy often neglect their children and don't even realize it. While there are also parents who don't care, either way, the child grows up wondering about their own self-worth and value. So, traumatic experiences like abuse and neglect have an advanced effect on children's brain development because they are being neglected. It's an abuse. And it affects their development, their brain development. They don't function like any other normal child would. Okay? So what happens to this? What happens to this to adults who were neglected as a child? So when a child is being neglected, they grow up as an adult. So this will have an impact in their lives. So because their emotional needs were validated as children, when they were a child, so their emotionally were not validated, so they may not know how to deal with their emotions when they occur. The most common effect of childhood neglect in adulthood includes post-traumatic stress disorder and depression. Okay, they are easily, you know, depressed over something that is not worth it. So that's it. The third one is the authoritarian parenting. It's an extreme strict parenting style. It places high expectation on children with little responsiveness. Most African parents, you know, parents, that's how they do. They expect too much from their children. I want you to be a lawyer. I want you to be a doctor. I want you to be an engineer. They don't even ask you what you want. No, that's not fair. Every child has a right to their own choice. You know, groom them, you know, like not show your children, not show them into good children. Tell them that they have right to make their own choices. The only thing you need to do is to guide them to the right path, not to impose your opinion on them, your choices. That's not right. So if you are doing this, you are an authoritarian parent. So they focus more on obedience, discipline, control, rather than nurturing your child. Okay? So this is not a good parenting. So the last one is authoritative parents. In this parenting style, the parents are nurturing, responsive, and supportive, yet set firm limits for their children. They attempt to control children's behavior by explaining the rules, discussing and reasoning. They listen to a child's viewpoint, but don't always accept it. this is the kind of parenting I would recommend. Authoritative parenting. So, and finally, I'm going to talk about hug. Hug is very important. Hug reassures a child. It makes a child to know that they are welcoming. They are, you know, they feel belonging. Okay, reassurance. So hug your children regularly. If you don't do that, please start doing it today. This turnout, there are important scientific reasons why hugs are good for you and your child. A 20-second hug can help your child grow smarter, healthier, happier, more resilient, and closer to you. Ladies, that's it for today. Next week, we're going to talk about the two other ones. I'm going to explain further, authoritative and authoritarian parents. Please, let's be good parents to our children. No yelling, no commanding, no controlling. You know, just, you know, keep it at, you know, at, be an authoritative, not authoritarian. That's all I think I can say, okay? So, but we'll give more examples next week, okay? All right. The meeting, we don't want to exceed 10 minutes, but it's gone more than 10 minutes. So, we have to go. Please watch this video and leave a comment below. Let us know what you think about this. So, the remaining one, we're going to talk about it next week, okay? All right, thank you so much for joining, for coming to watch this video. God bless you. Love you all so very much. I'm still your girl, Obi Stella. All right, have a blessed week and love you. Bye. Good night.